come to realize that I'm kind of a different breed in that I kind of say stuff that most people don't. Like,
I love that.
Earlier today when I said to you that you got a black girl body.
I do.
Most
okay.
people wouldn't say that. I have learned that I need to preface it by like, I really hope that you do not take this the wrong way.
When you said that first, I'm like, what is she going to say?
Because here's what I've discovered is that some people, and here's a generalization, this is going to be one of these awkward conversations that I think people want to have. So we're actually going to act this out for people. Mm-hmm. There, in my mind, there is a generalization that white girls don't want to have big booty. That you would rather have larger chests. And I've met so many people that, and maybe it's this is what we need to start breaking down, is that not to say that this is a white girl thing or this is a black girl thing, but the fact that we can have conversations about it, I honestly think that's the only way that the walls are going to be torn down. Mm-hmm. So as an example, why don't you tell me how you feel about bodies and
like that was honestly a really cool conversation that we got to have because growing up I didn't look like all the other like skinny white girlfriends that I had, and I always was like, man, I wish I didn't have like a curvy body of any sort. But as I've gotten older, I love that there's more like more types of beauty and more women are like so much curvier and saying look how beautiful I am, like look. And honestly, I could lose weight for 1,000 years. I'm never gonna be rid of these hips and this butt, like that's the way that God made me. And so it has been really cool throughout like my, I think my 20s, kind of seeing that there's beauty in that. Because I tried to lose it for a long time, and that's frustrating when you go, if I lose enough weight, I can get to look just like my friend. And when I realized I couldn't, that's where that battle comes of going, well, I'm beautiful just like this. And so I've started to like kind of embrace that and go like, okay, if I have hips, they're beautiful because they're a part of me.
That's right.
And like, so that's why it was honestly a huge compliment to have you say that. But I don't know if it would have been 10 years ago because I had to like kind of battle that for myself.
That's interesting. And so for me, I mean, you know, I've battled my weight my entire life.
Yes.
And I think there's a fine line because, for instance, I want my body to be the temple of the Holy Spirit. I want to be healthy. I want to be able to do the things that God has called me to do and not be hindered by my weight. And so I do believe that I have sinned in the area of food. I believe that the Lord is wanting to break me from that. He is breaking me from that. I lost a lot of weight several years ago. In 2013, well, 2012 through 2015, I lost over 125 pounds. And during that season, it was the best of my life. But then some things happened, including the death of my friend, Keisha, and I started turning back to food to fill that void. And so food became a comfort for me again. So I gained all 125 pounds back, plus 75 more. And so in the course of 3 years, I put on 200 pounds. And it's been such an area of shame for me. And so now, I feel like the Lord is showing me it's really not about the number. It's not about the scale. It's really about my body being the temple of the Holy Spirit. And I have a curvy body. Like, I have big hips. And no matter how small I get, like you, I'm always going to have that. And so I think there's a fine line. I want to say, because I feel like there's going to be somebody listening, and they're thinking that we are shaming them because they don't have big hips, because they're really slender, because, you know, they have straight legs. And that's not the case. I really believe that we are supposed to appreciate our bodies however they are.
Right.
And that we don't really need to compare.
Yeah.
Because I look at J-Lo, for instance. Can we just say that J-Lo has one of the best shapes? Like, she's absolutely beautiful.
It's not even, like, normal. Yeah. There's not a lot of those bodies walking around.
And I say the same thing about, say, Beyonce or something. But here's the thing. I think that God wants to get us, and Carlos, I'm going to be honest, I used to say that it was women, but now I'm realizing it's not. It's really all of us.
Oh, totally. Yeah, it's guys too.
I think he wants to get us to the point where we can look at how he created us. I love Psalm 139. It says that he knit us together in our mother's womb. Like, all the days ordained for us were written in his book before one of them came to be. Like, he deposited, like, he created our eyes. I've got almond-shaped eyes, and, you know, you have dimples.
Yeah.
And I just think we should really look at the things that he put in each of us and appreciate those instead of looking at that person and saying, I wish I looked more like that.